Okay, this graph is on inflection points, or inflection point of a graph. And let's get started. You put index 8 in here, you know, second alpha for the letters, and then alpha 8 in close parentheses, and that's the code for my menu to come up. Press enter. And here's the menu of all the different things that I have programmed so far. But we want inflection point. So we're going to scroll down here. They're all in alphabetical order, so we're going to scroll down to inflection point there. Press enter. And you can see that this is graphing by hand. You have concavity, critical points, crosses, x and the y axes, inflection point intervals of increase and decrease, local maximum and mins. All these come up in this graphing by hand program that I've designed. And so I tell you to, you know, mark, of course, on your graph paper or test this, you know, graphing axes. And then we're going to enter the function. So you have to press alpha first. Let's enter minus x cubed plus 3 times x squared minus 2. Press enter twice and shows you what you've entered. You can go back and change it if you want. I say it's okay. I'm going to press number 1. And you can get all these from that function. You can get all these different answers. But we want inflection point number 6. I'm going to press number 6. And notice that the way you do the inflection point is you take the first derivative and then you take the second derivative. Here's the 6 times x minus 3x squared is the first derivative, and then the second derivative is 6 minus 6x. And then we're going to factor it. You factor the second derivative and you get minus 6 times x minus 1 equals 0. So x equals 1, the x component of inflection point. And you plug that into the original function, which I show you how to do that here. Here's y, the original function, and we're going to put 1 in for x. Here's x cubed and plus 1 for the x on x squared. And when you compute that out, it comes to 0. So the inflection point is really 1 and 0. X equals 1 and y equals 0. Mark this on your pencil graph or label it, you know, as in, like I do, like you should example 1 and 4 or something, you know. In this case, 1 and 0 would be, you'd use. Pretty neat, huh? Check my website out, everystepcalculus.com.